Good evening, we are team CRC-PG079 and the company for discussion is Adani Ports and Special Economic Zones Limited as part of the Credit Research Challenge 2020. Mr. Gautam Adani promoted the Mundra Port and SEC in 1998 and the company changed its name to Adani Ports and Special Economic Zones Limited in 2012. In 2013, the company became India's largest private commercial port. Currently, it has Netflix assets at 22,000 crores and the employee strength is around 1900. The company's vision is to be a world-class leader in businesses that enrich lives and contribute to nations in building infrastructure through sustainable value creation. Now moving on to the industry, India already has 12 major ports and under the Sagarmala project, 6 new mega ports have been developed. We allow 100% FDI through automatic route in harbour creation, harbour construction and maintenance projects. Adani Ports and Special Economic Zones Limited is part of the Adani Group, which is an integrated infrastructure corporation. Previously, it had only one operational port at Mundra, but now it operates 8 ports in India. The business model of APSEZ is an integrated one through linkages which links ports, logistics and SEZs. It also has market leading numbers in marine, quay, handling, storage and logistics. The company is promoted by the Adani family and Mr. Gautam Adani serves as the chairman and the managing director. The company has always assured transparency, surety and accountability in all its financial transactions. It also operates through governance values like commitment, courage and trust in all the strategic decisions that it takes. We have performed the internal and external analysis of the company and the sector through SWOT analysis and portfolio courses. Moving on to the SWOT analysis, we can see that the company has high market potential due to the number of schemes that the government has launched, like the Make in India project. However, we can see that the threats are there due to the economic slowdown and frequent changes in the government policies. Also, moving on to the port of our forces analysis, we can see that the threat of entrants and substitutes is low, giving it a sustainable competitive advantage in the sector. However, we can see that the buying power of customers is high due to the presence of global companies in the market. Contrast to that, the suppliers and the rivalry is low, giving it a competitive advantage in the long run.
Coming to the company's financial overview, Adani Ports basically deals in four segments. They are ports and terminals, industrial lands, logistics and dredging. They are also listed in NSE and BSE with a major volume of shares in NSE. We did the peer comparison as well, and we found that Dredging Corp, Starlog Enter and Duke Offshore are some of the biggest competitors of Adani Ports. And here we can see that in all financial aspects, Adani Ports stands out with a market capitalization of 74,525 crore. Coming to the key positive and key negative aspects of the company, the strong track record in the ports and logistics business led to the strong financials, and this is basically because of the improved cash flows, because of the increased demands and increase in the operations at the newly commissioned and already operational ports. Coming to the three negative aspects, the first one is the high leverage levels. The company is dealing with high leverage levels because some of the projects are in the nascent stages and they are largely debt funded. Secondly, the concerns over weakness in core volume is also increasing.
Now let us discuss about the financial analysis of our company. We have categorized into four categories, that is liquidity, profitability, solvency and how efficiently our assets has been used. So let us start with the revenue stuff, where we can see that there is an upward sloping curve and later on it became stable because of expansion of our company. We have taken into consideration EBITDA as well in order to neutralize the differences of capital structure, tax rates and the accounting principles, and it has shown the similar patterns to the revenue. Now coming to our debt to equity ratio, it has declined in 2017 because of issue of new equity shares and redemption of our debts. And in 2019, it is approaching 1, which tells us that 50% of our total assets will be financed by debt and 50% of our total assets will be financed by shareholder funds. Now the sales growth has also drastically declined from 30% in 2018 to 0% in 2019, showing that there is no growth in our sales. Our assets also show a similar pattern, where we can see that there is increasing slope because of investment in our fixed assets, whereas our reserve and surplus are showing a similar pattern because of increase in retained earnings. Due to the past analysis, we can see that our inventory is going through a lot of fluctuation, and in 2019, due to increase in our inventory, there is substantial decrease in our turnover ratio, and this has led to increase in the operating cycle and delays in the cash inflows. Now let us discuss about the financial structure analysis, how our non-current assets are financed and how our current assets are financed. So talking about the non-current assets, it shows that it is financed by the two sources, that is shareholder funds and non-current liabilities. And in none of the years mentioned above, our current non-current assets exceeded these two. It is predominantly financed by the long-term borrowings. Whereas talking about the liquidity, our current assets is financed through the current liabilities as well as long-term funds. When we see the current assets, there is a lot of fluctuation in between. Because in March 2018, we have repaid the short-term borrowings, but in March 2019, we have raised a lot of short-term borrowings.
That is why current ratio has been on a substantial increase in 2018 and an equivalent decline in 2019. Quick ratio has shown a similar characteristic as per the current ratio. Now, these ratios, as we have analyzed, are above par or are on par to the industry standards. Now, coming to the key investment risk, here we have analyzed degree of operating leverage and degree of financial leverage. Also, here we have taken into account our stock performance over a period of 10 years. We have started from the period of January 2010 to up to January 2020. Here we can see that there is an upward spike at January 2014 to 15 due to the change in political power at the center. And although throughout it has maintained a constant growth. Now, coming to the degree of operating leverage and degree of financial leverage, both of these have shown a positive correlation and a positive simulation throughout 2010 to 2018. But since 2018, DOL has been on negative trend, whereas DFL has been on positive trend. DOL has been on a negative trend owing to its that fixed operating cost has been an obstacle in the EBIT part, and whereas the fixed income securities has always been given rise to increased EPS. Now we'll discuss about the shareholding pattern over here. The 63% of the shares of the company have been holded by the promoters group, followed by 21% shares with the foreign institutional investors and foreign portfolio investors. Now, the mutual fund holding have been the major shareholder have been SBI and its subsidiaries over here. Here we have given the buy recommendation for our stock because we believe that in a longer run, this has been a bright prospect because as per the quarterly reports in the industry, this has been a standout industry. It has always been there on the right side of the spectrum. Now, the buy recommendation is also supported by the expansionary strategy of Adani ports, and the government of India is also lending help to increase the import and export facilities in the country, thereby giving the more rise in demand for imports and exports throughout. So our buy strategy is in sync with the consumer sentiment in the market, because we believe that in a longer run, this will increase the shareholding income of the customer, and this will lead to major gains for shareholders. Yeah, thank you.